Welcome to the Getting Started with GeoStudio video series. This tutorial introduces the sketching tools available in GeoStudio version 9 products. This tutorial video has also been designed to help walk new users through the basics of setting up a geometry for the analysis domain in GeoStudio. So, if you are new to GeoStudio and are not sure where to start, you have come to the right place. We are going to start with the new project open with a steady state seepage analysis already added to the analysis tree. Currently, we only see a blank page with the Analysis Explorer and Solve Manager docking windows open. To activate our grid, we will go to Set, Grid, and turn on the grid display. Here, we can also change the grid drawing options if we do not want the grid spacing to be 1 meter by 1 meter. We can also activate the Snap to Grid option if this is desired. I will leave the default grid spacing with the Snap to Grid option activated, and now I can see the grid on my drawing page. Before drawing my geometry, I will use the Sketch Axes tool to add an X and Y axis to my drawing page, which can help ensure I keep within the desired domain limits. Here, you can change the titles of the axes, as well as modify the minimum and maximum extents of each axis, as well as the visible increments. I will set my maximum X axis to 30 meters and my Y axis to 20 meters. For now, I will allow the auto increments to remain active. You can use the zoom options along the bottom bar of your screen or under Set Zoom to change the view of your analysis, either to the extents of your domain or the extents of the work area page, or simply zoom in or zoom out. It can be helpful to first sketch the problem prior to defining the geometry of the domain. For developing a polygon, we can use the Sketch Polylines button and draw the outer dimension of our domain. The Escape button or right mouse click can be used to deactivate the Draw Polygon command. Lines can also be drawn to indicate objects that are included in the analysis. For example, the water level of a pond that will not be included in the analysis geometry, but can help the user visualize the problem. Arrows, circles, and arcs can also be drawn on the working area as visualization tools. These sketches are not included in the domain or the analysis and can be moved, modified, or deleted using the Modify Objects command. We will add a circle to the domain on the right side of the page where we will add a drain. The approach to use when developing a numerical model is to determine the geometry, assign materials, assign boundary conditions, and then finally to review and fine-tune the finite element mesh. So let's start by creating a domain. I will go to Draw Regions and draw my soil region following my sketch. Here, points will automatically be made wherever I use the left mouse button to click on the working area. Once the region is created, I can either draw a second region or use the right mouse button or the Escape button to stop the Draw Regions command. I will now add a circular opening to my region where I drew a drain. This will remove this section from my geometry so that it can be modeled as a hole in the soil material. If at any time you wish to change the radius of the drain or geometry scales, you can go to Key in Points and manually enter the desired X and Y coordinates of the associated points. To view the numbers of each point within the geometry, you can activate the point labels using the View Preferences toolbar along the right side of the screen. If this toolbar is not activated, you can simply choose View, Toolbars, View Preferences toolbar. Now I can see that the point defining the radius of my drain is point number 12, so I will change my radius from 1 meter to 0.5 meters by changing the x-coordinate to 20.5 meters. Points or lines can be added to the geometry in the defined view if needed for defining a new boundary condition. For example, where my water level in my pond meets my surface, I will add a point to the geometry so that the boundary condition of constant hydraulic head will not be added above this point. We have now reached the end of this introductory tutorial. Note that not all of the powerful features of version 9 of GeoStudio have been used or discussed here. Further information on each command can be found in the online help, supporting documentation, as well as in other tutorial videos of the Getting Started with GeoStudio video series. Thank you for watching.